In our final video about bras and kets, we're going to learn how to handle arbitrary vector spaces, we're going to learn what a dual space is, and we'll see how to make use of a basis. So let's suppose that V is some arbitrary real or complex vector space and that it has an inner product. As always, we'll think of the elements of V as being vectors, and when I write a ket, the ket y is the vector y, it's an element of V. And the bra x is not a vector, it's a linear operation. It's saying take the inner product of x with whatever your input happens to be. So that is a linear transformation from V to the complex numbers, the real numbers. Complex numbers if we have a complex vector space and a complex inner product. Real numbers if we have a real vector space and a real inner product. Now, the dual space to a vector space is a set of all linear transformations from V to the scalars, where scalars mean complex for complex vector spaces and reals for real vector spaces. So this is a vector space in its own right. You can add two linear transformations. You can multiply a linear transformation by a scalar. It's a perfectly good vector space. But it's not V. It's a different vector space from V. This is where the bras live. The elements are called dual vectors or sometimes covectors. So we've already seen this in the case of Euclidean space. If V is Rn, and Rn is a set of all n by 1 real columns, then the dual space, Rn star, is a set of all 1 by n real rows. That's linear transformations from Rn to the real numbers. If V is Cn, then V star is all linear transformations from Cn to the complex numbers. And those are described by 1 by n rows. And if V is an abstract vector space, well, V star is a different abstract vector space. Now, here, the set of all by n by 1 columns is n-dimensional, and this set of all 1 by n rows is n-dimensional. Here, the set of n by 1 columns is n-dimensional. The set of 1 by n rows is n-dimensional. And this is something that's true in general. As long as V is finite-dimensional, the dimension of V star is always going to be equal to the dimension of V. They're different vector spaces, but they have the same dimension. And in general, kets live in the vector space. Bras live in the dual space. So the next thing we want to do is we want to use a basis. The point of having a basis is to get coordinates. So if V has a basis consisting of n vectors, in other words, if V is n-dimensional, then the basis makes V look like Rn if it's real or Cn if it's complex. The dual space is then going to look like a space of rows. And we're going to have a metric matrix. Now the metric matrix before we got by taking the inner product of EJ with EK, because we were using Rn with a standard basis. Now we're using V with a basis B1 through Bn, so we want to take the inner product of two basis elements. Always, the JK entry of the metric matrix is the inner product of the jth basis element with the kth basis element. Now, the point of having a basis is to take coordinates. And you can take the coordinates of Y in the B basis, and that gives you a column. When we say the coordinates of a ket, we mean the coordinates of the vector, and that's a column. Coordinates give you columns. And I claim that the coordinates of a bra are going to be given by a row, and the formula for that looks very much like the formula we had for a non-standard inner product. You have to take the coordinates of x, then you take the transpose conjugate, and you multiply by the metric matrix. You see, if x and y are in our vector space, so that means they can be written as linear combinations of the basis vectors. So if x is this linear combination where the coefficients are a1 through an, and y is the linear combination where the coefficients are c1 through cn, Then that means that the coordinates of x in the B basis is the column A1 through AN. Coordinates of y is the column C1 through CN. If you want to take the inner product of these guys, well, you have to take the inner product of this sum with this sum. And that just gives you a sum of terms. And each term is going to be AJ, BJ, inner product with CK, BK. Now remember, when you pull an AJ out, you have to conjugate it. When you put a CK out, you don't have to conjugate it. And the inner product of BJ with BK is precisely GJK. So we've got a sum of AJ bar, GJK, CK, and that's exactly the sum of the product of a row and a column, where the row is A1 bar through AN bar times G, and that's what we called the coefficients of the coordinates of the bra, and the column is just the coordinates of the ket, which are the coordinates of the vector. Kets are vectors. So let's work an example. Our example is going to be the space of linear polynomials, and we're going to use the L2 inner products, so the inner product of one polynomial with another. So you take the conjugate of the first, multiply it by the second, and integrate it from 0 to 1. Now, our basis is 1 and t, and so we compute the inner product of B1 with B1, that's the inner product of 1 with 1, is the integral of 1 times 1 dt from 0 to 1, and that gives us 1. The inner product of 1 with t, you have to integrate 1 times t from 0 to 1. That gives us a half. The inner product of t with 1 is the integral of t times 1, which gives us a half. And the inner product of t with t is the integral of t times t from 0 to 1, and that gives us a third. So our metric matrix is 1, 1 half, 1 half, 1 third. So now let's suppose we have particular elements. Suppose that x is the polynomial 3 plus I plus 2 minus I t. Well, then the coordinates of x in the B basis are 3 plus I and 2 minus I. But the bra for x is not this. You have to take its transpose conjugate, so the 3 plus I becomes 3 minus I, 2 minus I becomes 2 plus I, and then you have to multiply that by the metric matrix. And when you do the arithmetic, you get 4 minus I over 2, 13 sixths minus I over 6. So what good is that expression? Well, if we have another vector, y is 2 plus 6t, then the coordinates of the ket y, or the coordinates of the vector y, are 2, 6. And we can compute the inner product of x with y by taking the row, that's the bra, times the column, that's the ket. We multiply it out, we get 21 minus 2i. And that's exactly what we would have gotten if we took the inner product from the definition. We took x of t, conjugated, multiplied by y of t, and integrated. So by multiplying rows times columns, you don't have to do the integrals. You already did the integrals to figure out the metric matrix. Once you figure out the metric matrix, you never have to do any more integrals. Everything is just matrix multiplication.